Softworks. This video is about deep cleaning of Dell OptiFlex 755. It does work normally. So this video will demonstrate how to perfectly maintain it and keep it on top performance. It have to be disassembled, clean from dust, and the new thermal compound have to be applied on a CPU and GPU. Let's disassemble the unit. By the way, it's running by Intel Core 2 Duo, Windows XP based machine. Hard drive have to be removed because we actually will do the deep cleaning. As you can see, the heat sink is pretty dusty. You can see it from this angle. Let's remove the hard drive. Disconnect the SATA cable, the power connector. Just simple as that. Let's remove this hard drive plate, which is keeping the hard drive in place. This was locked on locks, so simply push it down and you will be able to remove it. And don't forget to disconnect those electrical connectors, which are actually holding it on place. Here, right here as well. And you will be able to remove it. Let's remove the heat sink and the fan. Since it will be de-cleaning of this mini desktop, as well you have to remove the BIOS battery because you don't want any shortages to be occurred. Disconnect the fan. You probably will need to use the flat screwdriver because this connector is a little bit tricky. Just like this. The pin was from the other side. And he mounted on a rubber mount. So just simply remove it. Have to be deep cleaned as well, because as you can see there is some light dust deposits on it. Remove the heat sink. Before you will remove the heatsink, the second fan has to be removed. Disconnect the connector.
just press with your thumb right here and you will be able to disconnect it. Remove it. As you can see, the thermal compound almost gone from CPU. Remove the CPU. Be very careful there, because all these contacts are very precise. Remove RAM modules. The system is running on actually 4 gigs of memory, which is pretty good. 4 gigs total. And it's time to deep clean it.
There is some dust. Some dust deposited right here. Right here. Basically pretty much everywhere.
As well as the heatsink have to be deep cleaned.
As you can see, this is not good.
Everything is completely dry, clean, and ready to be assembled back. Completely dust free from all angles. All heatsinks, fans, no dust. This one is almost assembled. RAM and everything. The new thermal compound will be applied. I recently received more of those, which have to be deep cleaned as well. All of them are Dell OptiFlex. Dust is actually number one cause why most of the equipment failure. It could be desktops, laptops. That's why the same way unit have to be disassembled. RAM modules have to be removed. Hard drives, fans, everything have to be deep cleaned. Have to be dust free. The hard drives have to be removed on both of them. As you can see, the heat sinks are pretty dusty. Cannot obviously say it's a heavy dust deposits. Anyway, everything have to be completely disassembled. The thermal compound is almost gone, but not that badly. On the laptops, usually it disappears completely. Here is different picture. As you can see, it's almost gone, which is not good at all. Ready for the deep cleaning. I get some more experience. It's not very easy removing all those fans. Takes some additional time. That's why it's better just to keep them inside of the system. The new thermal compound will be applied after those two CPU will be cleaned as well. And make sure that you removed those BIOS batteries on both of the system, because you don't want accidentally to shorten something. Currently servicing a bunch of them more. Thermal compound is applied, the heat sinks are installed. Let's install the RAM modules on both of the systems. The BIOS batteries. Those are very fragile. That's why highly recommended. Be careful while reinserting the bias battery on place. Let's install the heatsink back on place. Bias battery is on place. Be very careful while reinserting it, because this is very fragile, the place where you position in the bias battery, the slot. Reinstall the heatsink back on place. Since one of those fans is actually bringing the air inside, always make sure that if you demolish them, make sure that you reinstall them correctly. They're supposed to be installed like that. This one brings air inside, and this one removes the hot air out. That's why there is an arrow here. Then to install the hard drive assembly, there is a small fan connector. Have to be connected right here. And this one responsible for the power supply right here. From here, just keep in mind that this SATA cable goes under. Reinstall the heatsink shield. Install the cover back on place and mount it on 4 screws. Everything working as it's supposed to be.